Espiritu Tuo. On behalf of the Benedictine Order, I am honored to welcome you and your Franciscan brothers to our abbey.
The other delegates, they have arrived.
Ubertino de Casale has been here for some weeks. The others are due tomorrow. You must be very tired after your long journey.
No, not particularly.
I trust you're not in need of anything?
No, thank you.
Well then I bid you peace.
I'm sorry to see that one of your brethren has recently been gathered unto God.
Yes, a terrible loss. Brother Adelmo was one of our finest illuminators.
Not Adelmo of Otranto.
You knew him?
No, but I knew and admired his work. His humor and comic images were almost infamous. But he was said to be a very young man.
Oh, yes. Yes, very young indeed.
An accident, no doubt.
Yes. Yes, as you say, an accident. Well, that is, Brother William, may I speak with you candidly?
You seem most anxious to do so.
When I heard you were coming to our abbey, I thought it was an answer to my prayers. Yet I said to myself, is a man who has knowledge both of the human spirit and of the wiles of the evil one. The fact is, Brother Adelmo's death has caused much spiritual unease among my flock.
This is my novice, Agil, the youngest son of the Baron of Melk. Please, do continue.
We found the body after a hailstorm, horribly mutilated, dashed against a rock at the foot of the tower, under a window which was, how shall I say this? Which was
found closed.
Somebody told you.
Had he been found open, you would not have spoken of spiritual unease. You would have concluded that he'd fallen.
Brother William, the window cannot be opened. Nor was the glass shattered. Nor is there any access to the roof above.
Oh, I see. And because you can offer no natural explanation, your monks suspect the presence of a supernatural force within these walls. Hmm?
That's why I need the counsel of an acute man such as you, Brother William. Acute in uncovering and prudent, if necessary, in covering up before the papal delegates arrive.
Surely you know, my lord, I no longer deal in such matters.
I am indeed reluctant to burden you with my dilemma, but... Unless I can put the minds of my flock at rest, I will have no alternative but to summon the help of the Inquisition.